It is a late night. They took away arcade mode so people would focus on the server testing, but I can't even play when they're doing that. So they've just hurt my feelings. I can't fight the AI with bad tires anymore. At least I can drive the Nürburgring. And apparently no one's gonna be able to approach their old times because they changed the tire model, but apparently it was a positive change. So let's take a look. My friend the Englishman has given me some settings to try out. Aha. Alright. Where are these settings? My friend is watching me and noticed some things that need to be changed with the tune, and he sent me some ideas, so I'm just going to throw them on and we're going to try it out. Alright, let's change settings real quick and test out the new physics. Yeah, let's do that. Alright. One last thing. Let's try that. All right. New tire model. Ooh, okay. That's new. Definitely feels different. I apparently need to remember that I can't break that late in that corner. Everything's a little more slippery. I might have also, unfortunately, changed the brake sensitivity for my brake pedal and my pedals. The one design thing I don't like about the Fanatec CSR Elite pedals is that... is that there's a knob that changes how sensitive the brakes are. And that unfortunately moves really easily. And I also have an adapter, so I can use it with this wheel. And so the only place I can set the adapter is right by the knob, and it changes all the time. I have to make sure I keep it in the right spot. Yeah, this is awesome. Okay, I need to start getting in a settled course of mindset. I need to turn up my brake sensitivity. Yeah. That did change overnight. Let's try this. There we go. Very interesting. Much slipperier.
It seems like the front end is just losing know you're still driving four-wheel drive, right?
Yeah. Yeah, but it wasn't having, it wasn't anything like that. I am back. That was interesting. Black Bean's back. This is really interesting. Black Bean, they have changed the physics. And I forgot that the Englishman gave me settings to change, and I've essentially turned the front LSD settings all the way up. But it's surprisingly, yeah. It was just because I wasn't braking enough or early enough. Happy Easter, man. It is the very early morning of Saturday here. Is it Sunday morning there? So, no one knows exactly, but in the patch notes they say tire model changed. And what a lot of people are noticing is that it's a lot slipperier. Yeah, it's incredibly slippery. I need to adjust all of my braking zones. I need to get really used to it. And the front end's actually grabbing more on exit. Like, a lot more. I think that's due to our friend's settings. I have to remember, I have a lot more steering than I'm using, too. I'm very tired. I just remembered that Easter is Sunday here. I was like, oh, is it already Easter there? That must mean it's Friday night here. Yeah, so, unfortunately, a lot of people saw me make that really embarrassing mistake live, and not a lot. It's not a lot of you guys. But it is going to be saved in my YouTube. And that's funny. Let's pretend I never made that hilarious mistake. Do you guys celebrate Easter on Thursday? I'm so confused. So I'm an idiot. Just learn that about me. Were you just messing with me? My 240? No, it's an S13. It's a hatch. So an RPS 13, I guess. Interesting. I'm not gonna restart this time, I'm gonna keep going. I think I'm gonna move the brake balance back now. There you go. I've got an S13 with a SR20 DET. Man, I'm gonna restart. This is ridiculous. Well, thank you, Black Bean. They're sport hard tires. And since it's qualifying for the actual online race, everyone has the exact same tire, power, and weight settings. There we go. This is definitely a lot more challenging, and I like that a lot. I need to drive better. Man. Like over a second slower. I did mess up a couple times, but to. Try to leave them around, leave them the same. So I get used to the tire model itself before trying to decide if it's the tires or the settings. I see how close I can get to my old time. Actually, I'm gonna change the front LSD.
Is it on all the way? Like, what is the setting on?
I turned up the front XL almost all the way. I can't remember what I had it at before, but I feel like it was like 15. I'm gonna turn it all the way down. And 20. The AOIC is not on. I've got the traditional LSDs. See, that makes a difference. I actually don't know if it's that or the new physics. I should have tested it out with my old settings. That does feel better. Definitely the old LC settings. It's 1,000 times better. You can definitely tell that it feels a lot different still. I'm having a lot of trouble locking up the brakes, actually. And I was coming close to locking them up like every corner last time. Last night. No, you can't actually adjust the brake power, and I didn't change them until tonight, and I've already changed them back. It seems like, it's hard to describe. Under braking, it's a lot more difficult to get it to slide. It's interesting. I keep driving like it's my old, braking points. Ugh. Man.
That's crazy.
Struggling a lot. I think I got really used to the old Gran Turismo physics, and they've really made it a lot less forgiving. I need to be smooth. It's not smooth. Yeah, I could, absolutely. I think I probably actually softened something before because of the physics. And they were. I think I'll try that out. I essentially just have to be a lot more careful. Yeah, it's a lot less prone to oversteer in any given situation. Which also means that I can downshift earlier and not worry about the shift lock messing me up too much. At least in this car. There you go. Definitely much slower than was before around the track. It's interesting they didn't change the leaderboards to go with the new tire model. It seems like they would have known it was slower too. Which would mean that there's just not going to be any activity on the top stars board. Unless they're hoping there's some magical driver that can figure it out and beat the old physics with the new. So I can get that sweet spot turning in and trail braking where I can get the rear end to slide out, but it didn't happen. Not at all. Seems like the turn in has been greatly reduced, but everything else has been, yeah, I just don't even know. I'm at a loss. What's that? I don't know, I'll have to check it out. Everything except the LSD is the exact same as it was before. And unless my brake settings on my actual pedals change a lot as well. Man, I am 4 seconds, I shouldn't have braked there. I'm 4 seconds slower than my best time around that split. And again, I didn't adjust for the day. All right, let's change settings. No more whining. Stabilizers will work really low. They don't need to be super high though, because the tires aren't even that great. Compression. I want rear bump even higher.
If you take your rear, if the rear, the smaller, like the ratio from the front to the rear sway bars, the more oversteer you'll have.
I changed way too many things, but let's go with it. See what happens. Awesome. Oh yeah. That was just my mistake. Now it actually feels a lot like it did before the update.
That's
such a slow time there. It's hard to tell because I've only driven this car. But I don't know. It's a possibility. I don't think so though. Jesus. Man. I think I need to switch cars and everything real quick. Go to the Tokyo track. See if that's gonna be any different. Oops. Oh. Anyone who's been following sim racing out there for ever, Porsche has not been in many games besides EA games, except for their stupid contract. But now they officially announced Porsche is going to be in this game, and that was one of them. Very exciting. Alright, we're gonna leave the Scirocco exactly like it was before, not change anything. And my best time is in it, so you can really tell how different it's gonna be. I'm afraid this car felt like magic. It didn't feel like any other front-wheel drive car I'd driven. Actually, except the Megane and the Focus RS also felt like they had way too much grip. This is the Volkswagen Scirocco, some weird GT car. I feel like it's not gonna feel like magic anymore. Still feels like magic. Awesome car. It seems like weight transfer has a slightly less dramatic effect in all aspects. Definitely not as sticky in the front on throttle. Where are you from, man? Full set capacity. Election white. Are you in the United States? It starts officially, I believe, this Friday or Saturday for Europe, and you've got to sign up on the website. You've got to just do a search for GT Sport Beta, and not everyone's going to get it, though. So you sign up for a chance to get access to the beta. I think that might have matched my old time. No problem, man. Hope you get in. It's a lot of fun. Definitely the best physics spin in a Gran Turismo game in forever. Let's see what time is. 1:24:503. Oh no, that's a full second off my fast time. And the physics are definitely different. And my brakes are turned way up. All right, let's go back to Nürburgring. I'm gonna avoid that oval. I hate that thing. Ridiculous. The smallest oval in the world. I don't know if that's a fact. Just feels like it.
I'll tell Scott back up to 50.
I think that's as good as he does. So did you see what he did? While they're just on the yellow flag, he's weaving, spun out. Super embarrassing, super amateur.
Why couldn't he pass anybody?
He's just not feeling it, I guess. Speaking of it, I hope I can drive this car like it's meant to be driven. I need to change settings again. I think that crazy rear bump setting I changed is way too much. Do that. And instead of just doing the, let's just stiffen it all up. Oh, I forgot. I also messed with the camber for no reason. I'm gonna put that back to normal. I'm probably just reduce it a bit. So tow out. All right, here we go. Wish me luck, everybody. That's from the fully customizable transmission. It definitely doesn't sound like that by default. All these settings feel way better. Definitely a lot easier to get a little bit more bite just on liftoff with these settings. Too much speed in that corner. Using a ridiculous line and failing. There you go. Yeah, the sounds have been greatly improved. I wish they'd let us play arcade mode so we can hear the other AI, the cars in the AI. The sounds have been, the sounds are definitely the best they've ever sounded in a Gran Turismo game. So much better. I still screw up, man. Disheartening because I haven't driven this bad since I first got the game. My first lap was better than this. Actually close to the time I was getting before the physics change.
What time was it?
It was a 51.6 there. Finally adjusted my braking zone. Better. 139, John. Can't remember what it used to be. Curves are still really forgiving. Way slower. That's not good. Forgot what court I was on. Way too much. That was fun though. Man. I apologize, loyal viewers. I have yet to drive this bad in this game. Use like full braking. Get this thing to slow down. Seconds slower than my best at that point.
Well, you're also drifting.
Forgot about that. That's a good point. Might be getting used to it finally. That's good. I wonder if the real reason they took arcade mode off is because people were using it to try to drift. And that exposed weaknesses in the tire model. And they didn't want to have shown. I bet that's exactly why they really did it. Come on, UPD. Love you guys. Come on. You carrying way too much speed into the corners. I think that's it. The cornering grip has been greatly reduced. So I assume that at these speeds I can take these same corners. But I end up flying through them and sliding sideways. It is. It hurts my feelings. It would hurt my feelings a lot less if they reset the leaderboards. 2.5 seconds. No. 3 seconds slower. There's yeah. How did I get the brake press? That was in the rear. I wonder how long it's been like that. How dare you? I get a break later on that. I just wanted to be careful and actually make it through. Now that I've done an actual lap, I'll have splits and let's see what I can do. Every inch of that track. Alright, I'm feeling a lot better. Slower. Interesting. Half seconds slower than the last lap. That's funny. Actually, the curves are a little more slippery than the throttle. Still really ridiculously forgiving when you hop up onto them now. Slide. Again. Silly me. The verdict is, so far, you have to be a heck of a lot more careful under braking. You gotta be a lot more careful, period. I think the physics change is definitely a step in the right direction. No, I never actually really did much drifting. The hope is I could make it my daily drifter. And it just kept breaking down too much. There's always something wrong with it. I made a really bad purchase, honestly, when it came to the motor. So after 7 years, it's now in my garage, and now I've got the other car. But I got a really exciting email today. I might be doing some more stunt work this coming year, because I might be able to pour some money into making it just my dedicated drifter. And there are a number of events here, year-round. Or I could even just take it to a track day. See what I can do with it around the track. I really like the local track. It's called PIR. It's actually in one of the Need for Speed games. I don't know what it's called. It's pretty awesome. Yeah, I hope it all works out. I've been dreaming of having a drift car since I was 16, man. 16 years ago. Yeah, I should have been more careful in that braking zone. That was a little sketchy. I'm really getting the hang of this thing. I really don't think I'm going to approach my record. I really do think it's a lot more slippery, but in interesting ways. Like, it's not as simple as just saying it's more slippery. It seems like there's less slip angle with the tires. Like, I've got a lot less to work with. Good job, man. Well done. I hate that oval. It's fascinating, though. Like, I sit there, I'm like, I don't want to do this. And I'm racing around, I'm like, God, I'm almost getting dizzy with how small this oval is. And then I'm like, I bet I can get a tenth faster, though. Let's try that again. It's, like, addictive. I always put down, like, 20 laps. Ah, I had to throw it away. All right. Let's try this again. I don't remember all my splits, but 8:14:09. I forgot, guys, I should have a new car too. I wonder what car they'll give me. Now that I've gotten over the initial shock of the difference in the physics, I'm starting to think this is quite a bit more realistic. That beat my time at Tokyo. That's an awesome track. And that's a slow first sector. So they changed the tire model, and there's no way anyone's going to be approaching their old fast times. Z06 Fun, I think he's first or second on the leaderboard for this, said that he couldn't get within a couple seconds of his fast time from yesterday, or the day before yesterday. There you go. What car do you have right now for the Tokyo? I was lucky enough to get that Scirocco. That thing's fast around there. You guys hear my voice today? It's ridiculous. I'm pretty exhausted, if you couldn't tell. Had a really good training session, worked all day. Yeah, they changed the tire model. It's a lot less forgiving. It does seem a bit more realistic, actually. So I'm enjoying it. Even though I'm doing terrible right now. For those of you watching right now, I don't think a lot of you are in the United States. I think some of you are. But it's 3 o'clock in the morning here. Actually, the Mustang's awesome. I wouldn't say near death. I haven't had a lot of big injuries. I've had less than 5 big injuries in my class in nearly 11 years. But I did have a kid who I don't think watches. Nathan, if you're watching, I'm gonna tell your story. But the young man did really well, and he was leveling up really fast in my class, doing a lot of tricks that he shouldn't be able to do super fast. And I warned him, but I also kind of had confidence that he'd be able to do it. And he was going to try standing backflips on the floor. And because of an experience with doing backflips, he had it totally fine, but then freaked out. And I should have known. And he froze upside down. And when you freeze, you kind of expand your body, which slows down the flip. And landed directly on his head, tweaked his neck. He's been back, though, ever since then, and he's actually in my advanced class now. I've had a kid break his thumb because he decided to do a cartwheel with his fingers and his thumbs. And I had a couple ladies. Actually, I had just one lady break her ankle. But it was kind of a freak accident. She was doing a pretty simple technique. She just came down on it. I think she didn't do a lot of sports when she was younger, so her body wasn't conditioned. Overall. I think I've probably hurt myself in my own class more than any of my students. I'm unfortunately very accident prone. For training. I've been minimizing it over the past few years. But I spent too much time sitting like this, which just ruins my legs for kicking and flipping. So after I get out of this chair, I've got to do a whole bunch of stretches and mobility exercises to make sure that when I wake up, I'm going to be able to move again. I would absolutely poop my pants in that corner if I did that in real life. So funny sitting here in a sim, you're like, oh, I'm sliding sideways and under braking over a crest at like 100 miles an hour, but I know I can hang on to it. In real life, I would have pooped my pants and the pants of anyone near me. What am I doing? I think I'm gonna poop my pants too much. I forgot to try. In previous Gran Turismo games, you could like trail brake really hard into a corner, and as soon as it started sliding, with a pretty, it was pretty easy to catch it. So you balance it out with the throttle, and so the rear the white goes over the rear, and you can just blast out of it. But it's not exactly realistic. And did you see, Patrick? Did you see that? Like, no one who got the invite can actually play it. It's really weird. Like, everyone who got the invite apparently got an email that said that they can't play it till Saturday because it wasn't officially supposed to happen on Friday. I'm wondering if Sony screwed it up. Black Bean, I wanted to paint a colorful, mostly brown picture for you. I hope you get it, Patrick. It's really interesting. That's so weird. Like, why would they give it out? There's so many different times of getting gotten screwed up, though. SLS AMG is a really good car. How could you do this to me, Black Bean? Sorry, buddy. This guy, I wouldn't say we're friends, we barely interacted on Facebook, but he's a GT Academy finalist. He was one of the, I think, 12 that got to go to Silverstone. He still doesn't have his American invite. Shoot, I was supposed to break there. What? You're listening to us talk about kicking and stuff and my students? Is that what you're talking about? Oh, I don't have a PS4 Pro. This is a launch PS4. Launch PS4, Patrick, is that what you're talking about? Fan kick up high. Oh, got it. No. It is not. Sorry. I'm never as good at multitasking as I think I'm going to be. I almost never hear the fan on my PS4. God dang it. Sorry, guys. Those are disgusting, okay? Especially their giant four axes. Nice, Patrick. I almost get crazy knots when driving. I am way too tense when I drive. I'm sitting there like using my entire body to turn instead of just relaxing through it. Sketchy. Working on overtime just to do something basic. Yeah, I have really short arms. If I put my back into this thing, I have to reach almost. I think my seat's just uncomfortable too. And I have terrible posture, so this feels super unnatural. And if proper adult with good posture now. There's a half second slower in the first sector. I think I'm just a tense person. I've never been one to notice those kind of things, so it absolutely it could absolutely be happening. It might also be the stream though, because it seems pretty smooth to me. I can tell you the trees look two-dimensional. I'm usually focused so much on what I'm doing that it could easily have a bunch of screen tearing and pop up and I wouldn't even notice. Oh god. That's what I get for trying to read that message, that corner. Hey, Welp, are you Nutty Hooligan? Or do I know you from somewhere else? None of the names line up with PSN names, so I never know who I'm talking to. 2 seconds slower. Dumb boost. Not that I've seen options for, Alex. There might be some automatic things, I don't know. Oh. I was like, I think I know who that is, and realized that I absolutely have no clue. until you told me that is. Hey, Mary Jane, your holiday's coming up. It's a Thursday. I know this because it's my coworker's son's birthday. Where are you from, Mr. Obama? Are you in the United States? Are you talking about how do you get the beta? Or are you asking like how to start sim racing? Getting conflicting information here, guys. Do you mean Germany? Obama? Germany, yeah. So, you gotta sign up for it. And then, some people have gotten a code already. But it doesn't officially start till the 15th. I believe Patrick said at 3 p.m. Realize since I already threw this lap away, I might as well try to get a little sideways. Just gotta put the sport tires on. I got to train with a couple guys from Germany tonight. They're in Portland for a couple weeks and they're gonna go off to the World Cheerleading Championships. And before you start making judgments, if you guys haven't seen professional cheerleaders, they're freaking crazy. The guy was warming up with a backflip triple twist. See if I can not screw up this time. I got the T300RS with Fanatec pedals with a CPX adapter from Basher Boards to make it all work together. Too much? That was too much. Lost a lot of speed there. Yeah, so I have a theory on that. I don't think they really are trying to force people to focus on the server time. I don't think the issue is people racing in arcade mode during the server, the open server time. I think they don't like the fact that people were trying to drift it and then explore the physics. What am I doing? Restart this. Guys, I just realized what time it is again. This is probably gonna be my last lap. I missed my G27. I didn't know you could get an adapter like that, and I was in the market for a new wheel anyway, so I picked this up, but I still love my G27. That was interesting. We're going to try something a little different. It seems like you get less understeer. There's a discussion a little bit in GT Planet about how there seems to be a hidden driving aid that gives you a natural understeer when you're sliding, and I didn't feel it then. I was able to lift off and get a little bit more oversteer as I was manipulating the throttle. The G27 with an adapter will work. Actually, any wheel with an adapter will work on PS4 if you have the correct one. Thank you, I really appreciate that, man. I have been driving this track since GT4. It is my favorite. But I really appreciate that. Thank you. This is my favorite track in the world. This is a tough track, man. My wife graduates nursing school. We know some people in Germany. We're gonna go visit. Lots of K's, yeah. Lots of K's. I think I like the new physics. United States. So the semifinals, the 32, the year that I went, got to go to New York. And then the top 12 out of that went to Silverstone. So jealous. What kind of car did you have? T500 is off. This is the T300. Macon, Lima. Actually don't know what that is. I know the brand Skoda. I have no clue. What kind of car? Is that a sedan? Is it a coupe? Is it a quad turbo V12 van? That'd be cool. I mean, driving anything on this track is amazing. I know that I'm, like, I know this track like the back of my hand, but I'll drive like a wuss when I finally get here. Nice. Front wheel drive, all wheel drive, rear wheel drive. How you doing? Thanks for stopping by, man. Everything's good. I'm exhausted and I'm sore. I'm good. Do you have to work again? Nice. I'm jealous. I will have to work today. But it's actually, it'll be my Friday. And I actually get to spend time with my wife this weekend. We're gonna go go-karting. It's gonna be a lot of fun. I have a Turbo 240 SX and a C6 Corvette. Mr. Obama, that sounds like a lot of fun, man. You really, really have to balance the car under braking in the new tire model. I'm really enjoying it now. It was really messing with me at first because I got so used to the tire model before. And so I had all my braking points locked down and the method I took for each corner. But now everything's just a little different. Ah, yes, sir. It was surprisingly cheap over here. So the type of person who buys a Corvette over here, the average age for a Corvette owner is 59. And so the average person who buys a Corvette new, it's usually a gentleman who is retired or about to retire or just does really well for himself. So he buys the Corvette, and as soon as the new generation comes out, he's like, I guess I'll just trade this in or sell it for incredibly cheap. And so I was looking for an STI, 2006 STI, and my 2006 Corvette ended up being less. Girl cars can be cool. What's your girl car? What? Do you have footage? Was it terrifying? That is one of my greatest fears, man. Hey, it's a Mercedes. Girl car or not, if you're driving to work in luxury, my friend. And damn, Mr. Obama, that sounds terrifying. I forgot about that. I saw the preview on Jalopnik. I never actually read the article or watched the video. Oh, I need to watch that. Forgot what I was doing. We might not survive this, guys. I think we would have survived, but we'd have had a bad day. Guys, I have to try something. Yes! Thank you, Gran Turismo. Guys, in previous games, they took away your ability to really do a J-turn. Possibly because it was too difficult for your average person to you know, reverse and not die. It's pretty cool. 10K per strut. I like the way you put that. So Mr. Obama, unfortunately, are you talking about like the body damage? Because there, I don't think there is any. How do I change my view? Oh God. Oh no. Yeah, let's restart like that. Yeah, just little scrapes. Cannot drive like this. This is like definitely an advantageous viewing position, but I can't do it. All right, here's for you, Mr. Obama. No, you're all good. I don't mind checking stuff out, man. This is fun. Look at that. So no actual deformation. It's like someone threw their Hot Wheel against the wall. I didn't think of trying. You owe me no apologies, my friend. Hold on. It's working. Axis spin. Fun fact. I didn't give a damn about time trials or racing. I got into Gran Turismo because I love drifting. Patrick, I don't know if you're watching, buddy, but I can't join your party right now, but I apologize. In fact, I have to... You guys would not believe how late it is. Alright. Guys, I'm calling it a night. Unless you want to see me do something ridiculous. You have anyone... Wait! We have to see the car I earned. Maybe it'll be rear-wheel drive and not a race car. But it is 3:30 in the morning. I did not get a car. It hurts. That's not fair. Oh well. Oval. I will see. Let's do a little bit of the oval. And that's it. Just for you. I keep looking at the words like I'm looking at you and then looking at the camera like, oh. Ah. That is when I'm going to get to work tomorrow or today. Oval. You were so convincing that I even started cheering for the oval. All right, what am I going to use? My Z4 is tuned for Brands Hatch. I don't know how we'd be here. I just got the F-Type. I think people were doing good things with the F-Type. Or we got the F-Type. I don't know. My friend described is, I think it was this generation. The F-Type is like the British Corvette. Big ol' butt. Front engine rear-wheel drive V8. I do. But I'm also in the U.S. Oh. Yeah, I like this car. I will check your time directly after this, my friend. See if I remember how to drive. Probably forgot again. Yep, forgot how to drive again. Is that good? Good. That's how you're supposed to take that corner, right? You'll have to enter in the beta. You gotta be a little quicker than that. So, I will start this off by saying that I think I was at my limit. I don't know if I could have driven any faster before the tire model changed. But there's no way you can even approach. Take care, Mr. Obama. Thanks for watching, man. Yeah, with the new tire model, no one's gonna approach their old times, even close. Did it really? I see you typing, but I can't look. I finally got a rhythm down. Oh god. I hope they do. This is terrifying. Hey, now it's counting my miles for the daily marathon, driving marathon. All right, we're gonna keep going on this oval until I get it, and then I have to go to sleep. 14.438. Victor's real fast. Where'd you drive? Who's your girl? That girl's incredibly fast. You got me. All right, you told me that, I forgot. Oh yeah? Yeah, I don't think I'm gonna beat you, man. I don't think I'm gonna come close. Let's see what else we got. How dare you get me stuck on this? I need to leave. Yeah, that's what I failed at last time. It's not your fault. It's not your fault. I like this car. Sort by power. It would make sense that higher power would look better for an oval, wouldn't it? Now we're already here. See what happens, kid. How did I get the beta? We just had to sign up. Where are you from, Frankaberry? If you're in the United States, you can sign up at any time and potentially get selected. Europe opens up on the 15th, and I don't know about the rest of the world. But some people not in the United States with a US account have successfully gotten in. But I don't know how much they frowned upon that. They actually removed the arcade mode. And I have a theory on why, and I don't think it has anything to do with them wanting to test the servers. I think a lot of people were... I think a lot of people were trying to drift and exposing weaknesses in the physics model. And then there are people like me destroying the AI on comfort medium tires on professional mode. I I have no patience for this. I like know that I shouldn't be doing the things I'm doing, but I'm holding the wheel right. All right, gotta give it a real try. As soon as I start really trying, I come crazy understeer. It's weird about the arcade mode. All right, one more car. Summit by power. That's so weird, Frankleberry. Why would they do that? Eating up my sleep, man. I just realized I even have to be at work on time tomorrow. I am unfortunately perpetually 10 minutes late. It's always only 10 minutes, though. Been that way for like 9 years. No matter what, if I wake up early, I'm like, oh, I got time. Money, dude. What? Oh, you can't change any of this. Money, why do everything? Whenever I see their screen name, Righteous One, it reminds me of the Bone Thugs and Harmony. I don't even know what time I'm going for. I'm not slower. Oh yeah, for sure. Gotta protect the brand. Hi, PSC. How can I get this bad at this game? Super funny. Yes, I'm terrible. We have our first troll, everyone. Yeah, I'm really no good at the oval. I got you, Righteous One. I can go to sleep now. Thanks, man. I thought you were serious. I always wondered how I'd actually deal with a troll. I'm like, I can't really say anything. I do kind of suck right now. Who's your girl? She's in this car. Got you, bro. Shouldn't have egged me on. I apologize to those of you who just finally said hi or who just watching, but who just started watching, but I've got to go to sleep. It is very close to 4 a.m. here in the United States, and I have to be at work soon. Thank you, man. Me too. I should be back tomorrow night. Probably not with a lot of stuff to do because they took out Arcade Mode. I'll probably just keep laughing. But wait, hold on. Did I get my mileage? Did I get no mileage that time? Did I hit the wrong button? We may never know. All right. I have to see if I got my car first. Now we do that awkward thing where I already say goodbye. You guys already say goodbye. It's like when you're trying to leave a place and you say goodbye to someone and then you both end up walking the same direction. You're like, do I pretend like they're not there? Do I slow down so they can speed up? What if they go really slow? Do I try to walk fast? What do you do? What you do is you go back to the main menu and see if you got your 26 miles in today. And that is wisdom from Cyrus. Dang it. I went 23.8 miles today. Okay. Why are they doing this to me? Perfect. Oh. It's the Michelin man. I think Michelin is one of those companies that American people don't realize is not an American company. Fifth gear. Alright, I need like 3 miles. I believe that'll be 2 laps here. You have a beautiful voice. A beautiful typing voice. Why am I in sixth gear? What am I doing? Those are speed walls. If you hit them right, you'll get them speed. All right, let's see if I can beat my personal record. Yeah, it's a really, really ridiculous front-wheel drive car. So weird. It makes you feel better. All the racing times in the United States, I'm at work at the time. Yeah, so I've never enjoyed a front-wheel drive car, ever, until this one. Rest assured, that was my problem, not the car's problem. I just drove like a jerk today. This Friday I might actually get to do a live race. I'll definitely stream that if I can. My live race record is 3-0, but that's only because they team people up with me based on sportsmanship and not qualifying times. So in the Nürburgring, I qualified something like 13 seconds faster than the second fastest guy. At Brands Hatch, I was 2 seconds faster than the second place guy, and I was 16 seconds faster per lap at Brands Hatch than one of the guys. It wasn't exactly a fair race. I literally just never saw them again after I took off. So Tribe, if you're in the United States, you can sign up for the beta on the official Sony website. If not, you have to be in the UK next, and you'll get to race on the 15th. And I don't know about the rest of the world, unfortunately. But anywhere in the world, if you have a US account, you might get lucky. I've seen a few people with US accounts from other countries get it, but I wouldn't suggest it. So you gotta sign up for the beta. I didn't even know this car was in this game. Yeah, no problem, Tribe. If you just Google GT Sport Beta, you should find the sign up page. There's like a full questionnaire now though. I think that's a class, yeah. That's this class. Oh, Saber Knight has one of those. Cool. All right, guys. Oh, Doodle Monopoly. I haven't seen that guy since GT6 or anything. He's crazy fast. He's like 19 or 20. Just stupid fast driving. All right, guys. Again, thank you for watching. It's finally time for me to go to sleep. Or as I like to say, perform the sleeping dance. In real life? I thought you didn't have this game. Do you really have a Ferrari? No. Maybe not. All right. I love every one of you dearly. Every one of you. Okay, so you did get in. Got it. Excellent. Not that I'd be super surprised. I mean, people have those. All right. I'm exhausted. I'm gonna say something silly if I keep talking. Have a good night, guys. I did it again. So you have to go through all these menus. You're going to still hear me. It's going to be awkward. I'm just going to fill the time with noise. Ah!